walking through the tunnel, you're just really just trying to get your head just focused onto the game, just not worrying about what people are talking about.
If you don't have a real strong team internally and a team that's motivated internally, you can get off track pretty quickly.
You just don't want to start 2-4, and you know you get tired of losses. You know somebody got to fight. So I think the leader stepped up and helped the younger guys understand the situation too.
Just to get back in the ACC hunt, you know, to win this game, this was a very important game for us. You know, it was a great team. It was 5-1.
I like to see what the field looks like, the type of condition it's in, whether there's a crown or not. Is there a strong wind in a certain area? You know, what the setup's going to be on the sideline. That's always important because some places it's really tight. I just try to really survey the whole field and just get a couple minutes where I can be by myself.
Just watching Coach Golden make you want to even focus more. You know, when I look at him, he always keyed in. He always has a serious look on, you know, and we know it's time for battle. Just watching him.
Every week the kids have offensive goals, defensive goals, and special teams goals, but there's always one thing that brings us together, and that's the cause.
It's got to come together today. Today is the day.
It was a 12:30 game. You get up early. It's all about your mindset. Like, do I want to do this or not? And that's what we've been hopping on all week, so we had to come out and start fast.
It's mental, because we can execute all the plays. It's just that now, mentally, are you prepared to out-execute the other team, do everything perfect, make sure everything is right? That's how you start fast.
It's one unifying theme or one unifying idea that we can all rally around, and that's really pivotal to the success of our team on game day.
North Carolina is not allowed a first quarter touchdown this year. They snap it to Benjamin running left. He is down to the 11-yard line. Very close to the first down marker. It looks like they're going to be short. It's going to be a fourth down.
I didn't know what coach was going to do. I just seen the field goal team standing there, and I just seen coach, and then he was like, go for it, and I was ready.
This one was purely a mindset. You can't say that all week and then come out there and the first time you're in a situation, like, you know, it's like the general saying charge, and then you go the other way.
Knowing the down distance, knowing the situation, knowing what you got to get done, I think we all understood you just need 1 yard. And so your football intelligence is kicking in.
You don't want to get in the first situation where, you know, you're 4th-and-1 and then you kind of back down to the challenge there. And so we just continued it, and I think our guys responded.
Snap, Harris rolling right side, throws, caught at the 10, Benjamin out of bounds, and a first down.
That's part of our brand. I mean, if you ask me what our brand is, I would say start fast, play fast, and have fun. I mean, that's the kind of attitude that we want to have.
Shotgun snap is good. Harris looks, throws underneath, caught by James, and he will drive into the end zone for a touchdown.
Just getting that first touchdown, breaking the water, silence in the crowd, you know, that's what we wanted to do.
Miami could not start this game in better fashion. Hurricanes score in the opening drive. Miami 7, North Carolina nothing.
I just think our guys, no matter what, they had, you know, the mindset that they were going to come out and play the way we're capable of playing early in that game.
At the 5, to the 10. He's in the 15-yard line, picks his way across the 20. He's explosive. Oh. Ball is loose. He's hit. The ball is loose. There's a scramble for it. Now Golden's right in the middle of that pile, and it looks like the University of Miami has come away with it.
Nathan Golston is the man who caught the ball in midair.
Coach Golden, he definitely gets excited when he sees the training come to the game, because as a coach, he's also a teacher. So when, I guess, we're athletes, we're his students. So when he has us out there on the field and he's teaching us different aspects of the game, when he actually sees the students perform them, then it's very exciting. So he's definitely very excited to see that.
There's Al Golden right in the mix. There he is right here. Look at him.
Certainly, I think we celebrate through, you know, our players and our players' actions. And I think that was a situation where we had been preaching that.
All throughout this last week, he was like, we need an X play on special teams. We need one. We need one. Whether it was a return or whether it was a turnover or something.
What made that all the more special was, here's a guy, Nate Golston, who's on scout team 3 weeks ago and has given such great effort that we put him out there 2 weeks in a row, two big games, two road environments, and he goes ahead and catches the ball in the air.
He's a walk-on, so him even playing is remarkable. So him getting a fumble, I'm really happy for him.
Some other guys have been in the game at the spot, I guess he wasn't quite seeing what he wanted, so he gave me my opportunity, and he said, hey, make the most of it when you get out there.
You need guys with that kind of character, that kind of makeup, that kind of work ethic in your program.
And the Hurricanes will have the ball deep in Carolina territory. Benjamin is the motion man. And it's going to be a play fake and firing down the middle for a touchdown. What a beautiful strike. Harris to Tommy Streeter. And Miami has jumped all over Carolina.
The way they approached the defense to take the running game out of it opened up some passing lanes for us. And Ja'Cory clearly was in rhythm.
Being that we prepared this whole week and we've been, you know, busting our tails to get things done, you know, I just knew that the execution was going to be there.
Fake the handoff, blitz, Harris firing, end zone. Gord Benjamin got him at the five. Travis Benjamin, corner of the end zone, touchdown! And it's the third touchdown pass of the afternoon for Ja'Cory Harris. A magnificent first half offensive display by the University of Miami. Hurricanes take a 27-10 lead to the locker room.
You know, as the coach, it's coming. You know, home teams just don't go away, especially if they're 5-1 and they're a good football club like North Carolina was. So you know when it's coming, and you just keep coaching.
Last week on 4th-and-1, Miami allowed a touchdown. They're going to dig in right here.
We didn't give up any points in the third quarter, and I think that was the best we executed probably all year. And I kept telling the players that on the sideline that you know, I felt like the reason they were getting off the field is because they were really executing a defense and doing their job, and there wasn't a play here or there where somebody cost us.
He did not get it. Miami held him.
We were obviously pleased with the progress there, and like I said, I think that stretch there, about 25 plays, we really played the best we did all season.
You're gonna have to do it probably 3 to 4 times. You're gonna have to stop them probably 3 to 4 times, including the 2 minutes and including the last play. You guys got me?
That's why we don't scoreboard watch. You know, he keeps all the guys keyed in. You know, he's going over certain situations. You never know what'll happen, and he's preparing us for those situations on the sideline.
Having done this now, you know, for a while, and called about 70 games, you know, you know what happens, you know what kind of game it is, and it just happened to be one of those games where their defense got hot in the second half, and I could just kind of see, you know, where it was going, and I knew we were going to have to keep going back out there and stop them.
4th-and-4, Renner, 3-step drop, looks left, slant for Jones, incomplete. Mike Williams had the coverage right on his hip.
Mike really squeezed the slant well. And again, I don't know if he would have done that 4 or 5 weeks ago. I think it's a great example of understanding the down and distance and applying your football intelligence.
Young players sometimes have a tendency to relax and don't realize how many more opportunities and how many times the game could change in situations.
Renner looking, throwing right side, man wide open, caught for a touchdown.
It was a learning experience for us that now we saw the other side of it. You know, another team having a slow start and then them trying to mount the comeback on us. Mm-hmm. I was sort of thinking as the game was going on that this is how the other teams must feel when we start to make a comeback.
And we have 46 seconds to go, so now we got to face an onside kick.
I kept believing. I said, oh, we finna get the ball, we're gonna take a knee. They ain't got no timeouts, game over. You know, but, you know, unfortunately, things happen in football.
Here we go. Onside kick, squid, right by Ray Ray. Armstrong balls loose. Carolina got it. Carolina got it. And it's not over yet.
I was nervous the whole time they're on the field. Just wanted our defense to make that one play.
Steps up in the pocket. Swings it out. Bernard is wide open. Makes the catch at the 35 and steps out of bounds at the 30. And Carolina can win it. And this would be devastating.
You know, it's like the difference between a link and a chain. And it takes many links to make a chain. And I think there's great examples in this game where when the whole defense is on the same page, it forms a really strong chain.
We've been prepared all through that moment. You know, Coach D, he was telling us the whole way on the sideline that, you know, this game is not over. You might have to go out and stop him 3 or 4 more times. So, you know, he was ready for that situation. And when we got it, we were prepared and we prevailed.
Renner looking to throw, looking. He is hit and drops, he's sacked. Back at the 38, Sean Spence brings him down.
We're looking for somebody to step up. In this case, we chose to bring more than 4, you know, again, to make sure we had an opportunity to win the game because the 4-man rush wasn't getting there. And obviously, The best guy I could call in that situation was probably 31.
Sean's a big-time player. When I saw Sean get the free release around the back, I just knew it was a sack.
He's looking. He is hitting drops. He's sacked.
Coach Golden and Coach Fizz always helping us when we do 2 minutes that we can't give up a sack. We can't give up a negative play. And once Sean got that sack, I knew game was over. I said, that's a negative play. Game over. They got no time. I was no shot.
17 seconds, 16 seconds, 15 seconds.
The sack in that two-minute situation was huge. You know, Coach D did a great job of calling a great pressure to beat the protection. And it was easy for me just to go make the play. You know, I couldn't have did it if he didn't make that call.
That was one thing I brought up to them after the game. I said, you know, it went down the way I told you it would, pretty much. You know, that's why 10 minutes left, I started talking about defending a final play because I wanted to make sure we understood it and, you know, that the game could turn into that opportunity. And, you know, it did.
The way we finished was something we not done before. It goes back when I said Coach D was talking to us, preparing for those situation. He had a feeling he was going to do a flea flicker and try to keep pitching it back. And he talked about how he was going to have three guys deep. You know, we was going to kind of be the guys that keep roaming to make sure it doesn't pop. You know, we did a great job executing and getting off the field and getting out of there with a win.
The clock runs out and Miami wins it.
It was nice to see us, you know, finally make a play to end the game.
After the final whistle, I ran up to Sean because he made that big play for us and we really needed that from Sean. And I was just happy for him and we put that game away.
The fact that those guys ran up to me in the game just displayed all the passion that could go to one to play with as a team and as a unity. They were looking for one of us to make a big play and we made it, you know, and we celebrated together and that's how things should be done.
To see the guys not only finishing the game, but then to have that kind of emotion after the game is, that means they're really investing in it. We needed them to finish the game and they did. So I think them celebrating as a team is kind of emblematic of what we were trying to get done in the game.
Coach Golden has given us many things. You know, our foundation, smarter, tougher, discipline, better condition.
He's a leader. Like, we're all 100% behind Coach Golden, and we don't question what he's doing. We just follow the program, and we believe in that if we do what he says, we're going to win.
Coach Golden has given us trust. He trusts in each and every individual on the team to do their job. And therefore, with him trusting us, it gives us that freedom and opportunity to go out there and just play our game.
The way you reinvested, it's not easy to do. It's not easy to do, and I thank you for doing it. I know the coaches did. You needed every ounce of it here today. Every ounce of it here today. That's hard. Okay, again, we told you they were a good team. Were they a good team?
Yes, sir.
They're a good team. Hey, it wasn't easy at the end, but you fought in there. Nobody panicked. Great job coming up with a play at the end. That's all it takes.
You got guys, you know, making plays, like Tommy Skreeter, you might say, you know, breakout year or whatnot, but Tommy been that good. It just had to be somebody to put the confidence in him. I think Coach Golden did that with all the kids. He put the confidence in him, he put the trust in him. So I think he just showed us the love he had for us. And, you know, we return the favors by winning or, you know, executing something he wanted to get done. He gets excited when you see a guy run down on kickoff and get a fumble in the red zone and turnover. So that's like returning the love to him and to the staff.
It's tough after a game because I'm usually so emotionally spent that I'm just kind of walking. I know sometimes people say hello, but I'm like, I don't see individuals. I just see a group. And then all of a sudden, I go by Nate.
He spotted me and he got excited, I guess, you know, thinking about the play earlier, pointed at me and he realized that was my family.
His grandparents looked just like him. And then I saw his mom.
So he came up and he just asked me, he said, hey, are you all proud of this guy here? You know, he's been doing a lot of great things for us.
I don't know what made me stop other than what a great contribution that kid's making to our team and the fabric of our program. End of story.
I don't have that one, nobody.
We're the ones to be thanking you guys.
Thank you, Greg. Yeah.